Hi guys, Kirk, Jason, and Madeline here with Kirk, Giordano, Plastering. Today I want to answer, a whole lot of questions that people ask me about mixing. One of them is, how much sand do you put for the amount of stucco added or cement plaster? Same thing. Another is, how much water do you add? Another is, should I use a drill or should I use a mixer that's designed for cement plastering mixing? Another is, how much additives or retardant should I use? And lastly, the water thing. Everybody says, well, gee, I mix and it splatters all over me. That's you using the wrong paddle, guys. And I can show you right now as an example and get my whole self saturated with cement plaster, but I don't want to do that. Anyway, we're in San Francisco. Remember that old saying, the coldest winter I ever spent was the summer in San Francisco? Try February. It's been raining, we're by the coast, and we are freezing our arse off, but I want to still show you because we still got to do some work here. All right, guys, as far as how much water to add, get yourself a water bottle, a gallon water bottle, a drinking water bottle, anything, and be consistent. Okay, for example, I'm just going to take a pan, my old cooking pan, and I'm going to put in it to the top. That's almost a gallon. All right, now in these buckets, I've got 3/4 sand and 1/4 cement plaster. Okay, what does that mean, guys? About this much on down is sand. About this much is plaster. So 3 to 1 usually, 3 parts stucco, 1 part sand. And what did I just put in here? I think this is roughly 3/4 of a gallon. If you're not sure, play with it, practice with it, get yourself some things. Okay, now as far as mixing and not getting it all over you guys, it's a paddle. If you're mixing, drills go both ways, and drills actually are for drilling, drilling in the wall. They're not really for mixing, but have we used drills for mixing? You betcha. I got every drill known to man with paddles for mixing stucco. They have these right here. This is a color mix. And they have many other mixers for cement plaster. I mean, they got one, $60. It's kind of like this. Anyway, this won't splatter you. And if you have the right blade, that's a huge part of it. This drill, I'm going to show you. It has these paddles right here. They make a mess. They get you all over the place. This right here, this color mix, has this paddle. And if I'm going interior, I use this. It's like a bird cage. Anyway, so say roughly there's 3/4 of a gallon here. Now, if I want to mix, and you can leave that water in here, guys. You just feel it. This particular paddle, it'll go to the bottom. And what is it doing? It's going clockwise. Why? Because it's pulling the mud to the bottom. If it was pushing it to the top, like some of these drills, I'd have mud all over my knees, my boots, my pants, and I'd be saturated before I even finished this. So now this right here, you just look at it, guys. Just kind of look at what you're doing. Don't do like me and don't look. And when it starts to spin like that, that's okay. What I'm doing is I'm going to be adding accelerators to this. Okay, that's not enough mud or that's not enough water. So I'm going to add a little bit more water to it, about 1/4, so it makes it a gallon. If I'm adding that to that, I'm going to put another 1/4 in here, another 1/4 in there. It really doesn't matter if I'm on the money or not because I'm going to add accelerator to it, luminite, and we're going to be one coating things. Okay, so I got another 1/4 in here. So this is a gallon of water. I'll show you the consistency when I'm done. I like this, to use this right here, guys, because the very bottom contours with the bucket. The sides contour with the bucket. If you use certain paddles, not like you use this paddle. it hits the sides and it scrapes the bucket. It just, we get all these little scraps in it if we're mixing color coats. But for mixing one coat, it's not a big deal. Then it hits the bottom, it just makes a big mess. Have I used them? Heck yeah, I'll use whatever's available. Jay and I were also in San Francisco about 6 months ago and forgot the drill. We mixed on the ground, so whatever works, guys. Okay. Hey, Madeline, bring me a hawk and trowel, please. I'll show you guys the consistency that it should be. And here's real important, guys. Never stick a dry blade into a mix. It won't work. It'll stick to the blade. What I'll do is I put it in water first, and I put a full bucket. Full bucket of water will usually hold a drill, barely. So get that bucket of water full. If it's half empty, you'll put the drill like this, and guess what? That bucket's going to fall over. If it falls over, like I'm on, oh, thanks, baby. I'm on shaky ground right here, a bunch of rocks and stuff. But if it falls over, the water hits the drill, which is plugged in. Don't do that, guys. Not good. Anyway, what consistency I want is something like this. And this is what you guys want, too. If you're mixing a scratch coat, a brown coat, you want that consistency. Beautiful. Now, this will hug the wall. That's perfect. I'm going to be one coat, so I'm going to add some accelerator to that. It's called Luminite. My brother, Lou, usually mixes. He's actually still out, man. He jacked himself up. Now, this drill here, I'll show you it because I can. Gonna make a longer video, but we want to get it wet, first of all, guys. Get that thing wet. I don't like these drills right here. You name it, I got them. They sell these buckets or these drills in a bucket. You buy a 5 gallon bucket, put it together. I got these Milwaukee's, Makita's, the ones from Home Depot. I got them all. Okay, now this particular one here, this drill, it's the same guy, the same thing, guys. This goes two ways. It goes clockwise and it goes counterclockwise. Either way, you're gonna get filthy, guys, unless you're really good. And this is, I don't want issues with this one, so I'm gonna put a little bit more water because I'm gonna add Luminite in it anyway, and I gotta soup it up a little bit more. Now this guy right here, you can see it kind of is a mess, guys. And I'm strong enough to control this and hold it in spot. Anyway, you guys can do it this way. I prefer to go clockwise myself if I got a mix with this. This ain't the greatest to mix, but I'll tell you what, better than mixing by hand or on the ground. So this, I'm pulling it down now. I want the mud to go down. I don't want it to go up. If it goes up, it's going to splatter me. So I've got the blades on clockwise. And again, because this old DeWalt here, this is a strong drill, guys. I mean, it's for lag bolting and things like that. It'll do anything. But to mix cement, it goes too fast. And when it goes fast, it splatters your whole body. Anyway, I'm just showing you the drills. There's all kind of drills on the market, guys. But I particularly like the drills that are for mixing cement, like these guys right here. There's a whole bunch of them on the market, guys. We actually do a lot of videos, and we point out, if you go to our website, that you can, it's a direct link to Amazon where we show some of these tools to buy. Now this one here, it's strong. It's stronger than that because it is designed for concrete, for stucco, for cement. This one here, I was about this far from the bottom, guys. I could feel it because it's like, dang, it's way up there. So this one is pulling it down. It's so much easier to use. You got two hands now. Now you're using your lats. Look at that. I mean, this one's easy, but the idea of this video was not to talk about drills. The idea was to show how much water and how much sand and how much cement plaster. And for all you guys saying, gee whiz, how much lime should I put in? None, guys. I'm going to show you the cement plaster we're using in a minute here, because we buy the bags that have everything. It's got lime in it, or additives. It's got common for strength. But if you just mix common only, it's kind of hard, but it's stronger. If you add just lime, it's easy to apply, but not as strong. So I buy the bags already, guys. And I've been buying the same bags for the last 25 years, guys. If you're going to Home Depot, I don't know if they have it, but all the plastering yards have it. It's called Premium. Lehigh's Premium Cement. I'll show you the bag in a minute. And for all you guys that say, well, gee whiz, man, let me save some money. I go and I buy bags of common. It's $6, and the lime is $6, so I spend $12. Well, I spend $15, guys. It isn't worth the savings of $3 to put Gibco in there and any other products to give it more strength or more durability. Let me show you guys, because we're getting ready to plaster. It's getting late, and I hate to be stuck on that bridge. Planter box, excuse us. Planter box, okay. You can cut out all that planter box crap, Jay. Here's what we use, guys. And I don't know if they sell this at Home Depot, because, see, I get 2 yards of sand put in here. 2 yards, about 2,400 pounds, and they just drop it right dead center. And I've been using this product here for as long as I can remember. It's Lehigh's, L-E-H-I-G-H, and no, I'm not affiliated with this company. It's just an all-purpose plaster, and it makes my life easier. Heck, we're trying to save $3 in buying the common plaster and adding Gibco or lime. Too much work, guys. It really is not worth it. All-purpose plaster and cement. Anyway, that's what I use. 3-to-1, guys, as a rule. If you're doing soffits and you're dealing with gravity, 2-to-1, because you want it sticky to adhere to a ceiling. Anyway, guys, my brother Lou is usually mixing everything, but he's up second month now. When you break the bones in your foot, guys, it's no joke. Anyhow, my name is Kirk, Jason on the camera. We thank you for watching, and as usual, live long and plaster.
By the way, folks, my dad and I are now members of Amazon Affiliates, so if you're looking to buy any of the plastering or construction tools you've seen in our videos, and you want to support us in the process, you can check the links below our video, or you can go to our website and get them there. If you have any other questions for tools we don't have linked, email us direct, and we'll respond to you then.
Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.